Now here at 4:30, the American Academy of Pediatrics is now recommending that all children 2 and older should be wearing masks regardless of their vaccination status when school resumes this fall. Now, joining me now to talk more about this is Keith Grant, an infectious disease specialist with Hartford Healthcare. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
A lot of people have a lot of questions about this. This guidance just came out today. Why do you think this guidance includes students who are both vaccinated and unvaccinated?
Yeah, so I think the document itself that came out was very well written and very well presented. They're primarily, what they're focusing on is, if anything, a layered approach, right? And they did identify that a number of students within the student body population this year are coming to school not vaccinated. There's a number of areas that it's not going to be mandated. So coupled with the, you know, what we're seeing is a significant increase in the, specifically the Delta variants that we know is more contagious. There needs to be some layered approach to this concern. And with our student body population, we need to put, potentially, according to AAP, we need to recognize the need for masking even in individuals that are not vaccinated or that are vaccinated.
I know, being a parent myself, I know a lot of parents are going to have a lot of questions. They're going to say, well, you know, my child or my children are vaccinated, but here again, we're being told we need to wear masks starting in the fall. What do you think the answer is going to be to that?
I do. It's a valid concern. I do think it's a valid concern. And, you know, people do have the right to have that level of discussion, and it's lived within science. Keep in mind, we've been saying for a long period of time, and we still believe that strongly. The vaccine protects strongly. The vaccine protects specifically against not just getting the disease process, but being and needing critical care and preventing mortality as well. So with that being said, why do I need to keep wearing a mask? Again, we've seen a number of breakthrough cases. You know, in Connecticut, we're up to 854 breakthrough cases. So that's something for us to keep an eye on, be a little bit concerned about. Although within those cases, there's been very small amount of individuals needing critical care and even smaller percentage of individuals dying. But at the same time, there needs to be a very significant process in addressing, you know, students going back to school and the potential risk that this will have.
All right, Keith Grant, thank you so much for being with us from Hartford Healthcare. I know we're going to be talking about this for months to come. Thanks so much for being with us this afternoon.
Absolutely. Bye, guys. Be safe.